Hey, Andrew Lamb here, owner of the Andrew Lamb Real Estate Team at KW Vacaville, and today we're talking about how often you should get your flooring cleaned. Your tile, your grout, your flooring, your wood flooring, laminate, and also carpet, of course. How often should you have that done? We're joined by a guest, Dave Johnson from State of the Art Cleaning Service today. And before we get into our question and answer segment with him, we'd love to let you know if you're looking to buy a home in the area, Solano County, Napa County, Yolo, feel free to click the search all homes link. That will give you a backstage pass to the MLS, all interior, exterior photos, full description of the property, and a link to a video if available. If it's our listing, it definitely has a video. And if you're looking to figure out what your home is worth in today's market, you'll want to click the home value link. That will allow you to see a good range of what your home could sell for, nearby previously sold homes, and allow you to get in touch with us directly if you need something more specific or you've done some recent upgrades to your home. Hey everyone, thanks for joining us today. We're joined by Dave Johnson from State of the Art Cleaning Service. Yes. And we're just talking about some common misconceptions about preparing your home for market if you're going to sell it, and about maintaining just a clean carpet, sure, clean flooring, or even upholstery inside of your home once you've already purchased it. So Dave, thanks for being here.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Well, number one, a question that we get a lot is, how can we best prepare our homes for sale to make sure that the carpet looks great, that, you know, you mentioned to me that you also do tile and grout, so that correct, that looks nice and clean.
Correct.
Could you explain your process and how to best do that?
Sure, absolutely. We do a multi-step process, beginning with pre-vacuuming of all the carpets. Mm-hmm. So with that, that gets a lot of the dry soils out ahead of time. We have a vacuum that's high performance, professional grade.
Okay.
We also pre-treat the carpet with a detergent,
okay,
in all the areas that we're going to be cleaning, and then agitate them with another machine that helps to loosen the soil and break the soil loose.
Yeah.
So we get maximum soil removal using less water so the carpets will dry faster.
Okay, perfect. And that process really, you're telling me, helps prevent resoiling or reoccurrence of stains showing up. Is that right?
Correct, because we actually rinse the carpet. We use a rinsing agent with hot water, and so that pulls the soap and the soil back out of the carpet, so you're not left with detergent residue in the carpet, which will cause resoiling.
Yeah, a lot of times, and I've seen this before, from some clients who didn't use our preferred vendors, mm-hmm, they just wanted to go like the much cheaper route.
Right.
I won't name a company, but just lots of chemicals and quick job.
Right.
So they'll go in, clean everything really fast, so it looks amazing initially. Just a few weeks later, it looks dirty again.
Exactly. And that's as a result of the cleaning process and leaving detergent residue in the carpet, which is actually not good for the carpet, and it's not good for the homeowner that just spent a lot of money to have their carpets cleaned to only resoil in 2 weeks.
Yeah. Quick question just kind of popped into my head because it is allergy season.
Sure.
So many people are suffering from allergies right now. How often should you have your carpets cleaned if allergies are a problem for you?
Well, yeah, that's a good question because I do get that quite a bit. A good rule of thumb is once a year to have your carpets cleaned. Carpet manufacturers actually recommend every year to 18 months, but it also depends on your lifestyle. If you have a lot of pets or you have your windows open a lot, you may want to do every 6 months. So that's just kind of a good rule of thumb.
Okay. And then you mentioned tile and grout cleaning. Can you tell me more about that?
Sure, absolutely. So we do tile and grout cleaning. We clean all sorts of tile, whether it be marble, travertine, ceramic. We're familiar with all those. And it's a great process. It's relatively simple because the dry time is very quick on it. But we have excellent results with that. And a lot of people, especially when they're looking to sell the house, it does make a big difference to clean up the grout, especially if it's white grout that now looks brown.
Yep, which happens a lot with the homes we have around here built in the late 80s, early 90s, tons of tile,
right,
that now, so many decades later, doesn't look so hot. So
exactly.
If you really want your home to pop in pictures, get that grout and that tile cleaned.
Absolutely. That'd be great.
Awesome. Anything else you'd like to leave our viewers with?
I just wanted to share that, you know, our company, we strive to provide the most outstanding service experience, 100% guaranteed for our clients. So if you're not happy, we will come out and try to make you happy. And if not after that, then you don't owe us anything. We do 100% money back guarantee for all of our services.
Awesome. Well, we appreciate you being here today,
Well,
and
thank
you so much for taking the time.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thanks so much for joining us today. If you have any questions, or if you have your own story of how really great carpet cleaning has helped you get a better value for your home, we'd love to hear from you. We have many past clients with stories like that that we've sent Dave out to their home and he's taken care of them. So feel free to reach out, reply to this message, or however you're seeing it, YouTube, Facebook. Let us know. We'd love to hear from you. And if we end up mentioning you on one of our future videos, we will send you a $10 Starbucks gift card. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.